Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and in this video I'm going to teach you drill check hacks that will blow your mind. The size of this drill check is 1.5 mm to 13 mm, so the drill bits that are connected to it are 1.5 to 13 mm. So what we are going to do is we are going to get another piece identical to this. So what you have to do is you have to find a screw that fits to the back of the drill chuck, and you are finally going to connect both the drill chucks back to back like this. Okay, goes here. Okay, so you have two back to back connected drill chucks. So now comes the hacking part. The first hack, which will be the most important, is to use the drill chucks as a variable shaft coupler. So here we have a 24 volts DC motor and a generator, and I am going to couple their shafts with this, with these drill chucks. The shaft size of this generator is 8 mm, and this shaft is completely different from the shaft of this generator. Yeah, these are completely two different shafts, and I'm going to connect them with a coupler. Okay, what I've done guys is I have connected a 19 volts laptop charger to this motor, which is going to drive this generator. See the voltage generated on this LCD screen of this multimeter. Look at the LCD screen. Okay, go. You can see it is generating around 74.2. So now I have connected a multimeter in series with this motorcycle bulb, and this bulb is only 12 volts, and you saw that the generator was producing around 73 volts, so I had to reduce the supply voltage to reduce its RPM. So now the voltage will reduce, and this meter is pointed towards the 10 ampere current reading mode. So you will see the current that is generated by this generator when it is rotated with this motor, and this bulb will glow eventually. So after giving supply to this motor, and when I will touch this red terminal of the multimeter to the black terminal of this bulb, then it should start glowing. Okay, so getting on with it now. Just see the multimeter and the bulb. Okay, go. You can see that the bulb is glowing, and the current required by the bulb to glow is indicated on the LCD screen, which is 1.28 or 1.27 amperes. So this is about the current and the voltage testing with the help of the shaft couplers. The second best drill check hack is making a drilling machine with a DC motor. So guys, this is a 24 volt Japanese DC motor which is geared, so it will provide the high torque which is needed for drilling, and we have these two back to back connected drill chucks and this drill bit. So now connecting this. So it is something like this now, and I'm going to use these batteries to power this motor up and drill this wood. So yeah, as you can see, there it is, drilling hole in the wood. Now I'm giving it a really low voltage supply. This is 7 volt supply, and it needs around 24 volts for full RPM rotation and full load torque, and then it will run better. So my point was just to show you the demonstration, which is enough for this video. You can see. So now I'm going to give it a supply of 19 volts from this laptop charger terminals. Okay, and still it is less, it requires 24 volts. I'm still giving it only 19 volts, but it will do the job pretty quick. Now to be held like this, I'm going to drill another hole. Yeah, now I'm switching it off. So you can see that it is doing the job pretty good. So yeah, we can use it for drilling as well. Now the last one is using these drill chucks to make an electric screwdriver. So we have our normal screwdriver, we are going to open it and it's like this, and we are going to connect it like a drill bit. Okay, when it's connected, tight it up so that it does not slip. So now I'm going to use that same battery to open the screws of this mixie motor. So these are the screws, as you can see, four screws. This is all are the minus screws. This, okay. So getting on with it. Yeah, so the first one is out. Second one is also out. Now coming to the third one. Yeah, the third one is also out. So the same way you can put it back in by reversing the polarity. Since it's a DC motor, it will rotate in the other direction to screw it back to the motor. The fourth one is no hack, but it is still worth sharing. So in this, I have connected back-to-back drill chucks as a pulley, and I have connected a bulb just for the measurement of load, I mean just for load testing. And I can wound this thread here. Okay, and you should see the generation by the glow of the bulb. Okay, go. So these were the three drill chuck hacks. Thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you.